Hello, students of class 9. So, today's topic of chapter 10, my dear students, the chapter is gravitation. We have already studied the universal law of gravitation. Today, I shall discuss about the thrust and press. What is thrust? The force acting on an object perpendicular to its surface. The force acting on an object perpendicular to its surface is called thrust. What is pressure? The pressure is the thrust on unit area. The thrust on unit area is called pressure. The unit of thrust, it is Newton. Whereas the SI unit of pressure is Newton per meter square. Pressure is equal to thrust by area. Thrust by area. And the great scientist Blaise Pascal also revealed that the unit of pressure is Pascal. The only that great scientist, the unit of pressure is also called Pascal. Now, just to understand certain phenomena that occur every day in our life. What are those phenomena? How a camel run in desert easily? Why heavy vehicles like trucks, bus, have much wider tires? Why cutting tools like saws, the knife, have sharp edges? So all these phenomena involve here to understand the concept of the net force in a particular direction. Net force in a particular direction, that is the thrust, and the force per unit area, that is pressure. Net force in a particular direction, that is thrust, and the force per unit area, that is pressure, acting on an object concerned. So this phenomena is concerning to the thrust and pressure. Now, to understand the meaning of thrust and pressure, consider situation number one. First situation, just fixing a poster on a bulletin board. Fixing a poster on a bulletin board. Just to do this work, what do we do? Just to do this work, you will have to press a drawing pin with your finger. Drawing pin with your finger, and you will apply force on the surface area of the head of the pin. Why? You are fixing a poster on a bulletin board. You will have to press drawing pins with your thumb, and you will apply force on the surface of the head of the pin. And this force is directed perpendicular to the surface area of the board. this force acts on the smaller area of the tip of the pin. As you know, the head of the pin, the area, surface area of the head of the pin is larger in comparison to the tip of the pin. So, while we press the pin, that is the head of the pin, on a larger surface area, but the pointed end of the pin is definitely a very smaller area. Obviously, the perpendicular, the force acting perpendicular to the surface of the head of the pin, and obviously the pin penetrates the bulletin board easily, and we can fix the poster on the bulletin board. Second situation, when you stand on loose sand, what happens? When you stand on loose sand, your feet go deep into the sand, but if you lie down on the sand, your body will not go that deep of the sand. But in both cases, the force exerted on the sand is the weight of your body. The force exerted on sand is the weight of your body. But when you stand on loose sand, the force, that is the weight of your body, is acting on an area, acting on an area equal to the area of your feet only. But when you lie down, the same force acts on an area equal to the contact area of your whole body. Thus, the effects of the force of the same magnitude is the same, on different areas are different. While you are standing on foot, the area of your feet is definitely less than the area of your whole body. Therefore, the effect of the thrust, on which it depends, the effect of the thrust depends on the area on which it acts. The effect of thrust on sand is larger while standing than while lying. While you are standing on the loose sand, the surface of the area of your feet, definitely the effect of thrust on sand is larger while standing than while lying. So, when you stand on loose sand, your feet go deep into the sand. And that is why you can see here, the force acting on an object perpendicular to its surface area, it is called thrust, whereas the thrust on unit area is called pressure. Therefore, the concerned phenomena, how a camel runs in desert easily, as you know, the feet of a camel having larger area, and that is why the thrust that is perpendicular to its surface area on sand, it does not penetrate the surface of the loose sand. And obviously, a camel can run on desert easily. So, all these phenomena depends on the surface area. Thus, the effect of force of same magnitude on different areas are different, and therefore the effect of the thrust depends on area on which it acts. While we are pushing a nail on the wall, we put the pointed end of the nail on the wall and we hammer, take a hammer and we press it on the head of the pin, head of the nail. So, here also the effect of the thrust depends on the area on which it acts. The pointed end of the nail, the area is definitely very small and thin, whereas the head of the nail is larger. Therefore, the effect of thrust on the pin, that is the pointed end of the pin, is larger while it is hammered on the head of the pin. The nail easily penetrates the wall and enters into the wall while we hammer. So all this phenomenon is concerned to thrust and the pressure. Again I repeat, there are so many phenomena that take place. They are concerned to the thrust and the pressure. How? So these things must go deep into the matter of this fact and try to correlate this phenomena with thrust and the pressure. That's all.